Hello students, in previous video we have seen some part of exercise 10, that is decimal fractions, conversion of common fractions into decimal fractions and conversion of decimal fractions into common fractions we have seen. Now moving forward in this, we are going to learn how to add, how to subtract, multiply and divide the decimal fractions. Okay, they are also very, these concepts are also very easy. Pay attention carefully. Okay, now see your first question. Simplify. In this question we are going to learn addition and subtraction. So see how to do the addition and subtraction of the decimal fractions. All the rules are same as we are doing usual addition of the whole numbers. Okay, just here different is what, these decimal fractions first we have arranged in proper way. If you are able to do that, then the thing which is remaining, that is just to do addition. First we have to arrange these decimal numbers in proper order. Now how to arrange? See here, first see here, 28.3 plus 21.528. okay, first we will write this number 28.3. After that, plus the next decimal fraction. Now while writing next decimal fraction below this, what we have to do, you know, first this decimal point, write exactly below the above decimal point. Okay, what we have done, first this decimal point write exactly below the above decimal point. Now before this decimal point there is 21, that is 1 and 2. So here write 1, here 2. Finish. There should be before decimal point is 1 and 2 tens, that is 1 in the 1's place, 2 in the 10's place. After decimal point there is 5 to 8. So 5, 10, it will come below this 3, 2 and 8. Okay? That means what, you know, in the first decimal point there is only one decimal place, 10, and in the second decimal number there are 2-3 decimal places, 10, 100 and 1000. We will balance it by putting just 0 in here. Okay, if you put 0 after 3, its value doesn't change. Just to avoid confusion we will put 0 in here. Okay, and now add. So the most important thing in the arrangement of the decimal number is putting decimal point exactly below each other. What students do, you know, 28.3 is there and then there is 21.58. So in some cases what the number is supposed this way, 28.3 plus 2.138, it is like this. And what they will do, they will write this way, 2.138, means the decimal point is not below exactly each other. This is wrong arrangement. Okay, so we have to avoid this. Decimal point should be exactly below that, below the above decimal point, and then according to that we have to arrange the numbers. Understood? So follow this, take care here. Decimal point should be exactly below the above decimal point. Now addition, we know that we are doing 0 plus 8. Here also we have to start from the rightmost digit. 0 plus 8, 8. 0 plus 2, 2. 3 plus 5, 8. Then there is decimal point. So put here decimal point. Okay. 8 plus 1, 9. And 2 plus 2, 4. That is 49.828. Okay. Next. 12. Now see this. 12 plus. Now where is decimal point here in the 12? It is not given. Where is it? It is there, but where it is? Before 12 or after 12? If you put before 12, then 12 becomes fractional number. As they have given exactly 12 means it is whole number. The decimal point is there, but it is after 12. So it is actually 12 means what? 12.00 or 12.0, okay? Plus 13.04. So first write this decimal point exactly below the decimal point, then here 3, here 1 and here 04. Okay, Now add 0 plus 4, 4, 0 plus 0, 0, 2 plus 3, 5, and 1 plus 1, 2. Addition is not difficult, just arrangement is necessary, proper arrangement is necessary. Next, 48.3 plus, sorry, minus, subtraction is there, minus, decimal point here, 5, 2, okay, and 7. Now let's subtract, 3 minus 7, now 3 minus 7, not possible. Here also same rules of subtraction we have to use. Now here 3 minus 7 not possible, then we can take borrow from the whole number. Okay? We can take borrow from this 8. From this 8 take one borrow here, cut this 3 right out. 8 will remain 7. Understood? Now 30 minus 7 is 6, decimal point. 7 minus 5, 2, and 4 minus 2, 2. 22.6. As usual, once you are okay with the arrangement, then everything is easy here, adding addition and subtraction. 368. Where is decimal point? 368 is whole number. Where is decimal point? After 8. Why I have put 2 zeros? Because there are 2 decimal points after here in the second number. Then write here decimal point. Now see here. Write decimal point exactly below the above decimal point. Now see there is 5 and 3 means 3 here and here 5. Don't write this way. 5, 3. This is also wrong. Okay? 3 is at 1's place, it will come below 8. And 5 is at 10's place. And after decimal point, there is 7, 6. Subtraction. Okay? Now 0 minus 6, not possible. So we have to take borrow from here, but there is also 0. Remember the rules of when there are consecutive zeros, cut first 0 right here, 10, cut second 0 right here, 9, and cut the previous digit right here, 7. Instead of 8, write 7. Okay, now 10 minus 6 is 4, 9 minus 7 is 2. Okay, 7 minus 3, 4, 6 minus 5, 1, and 3 as it is. 314.24 is the answer. Okay. Next, 25.5 minus 678.9 plus 548.7. Okay, and 26th one I will show you, 25th and 26th. 32.904 minus 0.276 minus 0.624. Okay. Okay. Let's see here. At a time, there are two operations, minus and plus. So when there is minus and plus, how we do? If you remember the simplify examples, first we have to do addition. Addition of two positive numbers. This negative number keep beside. Add two positive numbers. 234.5 plus this 8, 4, 5 and here 7. Okay, 5 plus 7, 12.1 will carry on. 8 plus 4, 12 and 1, 13. 3 will come down, 1 will be carried. 4 plus 3 is 7. 7 and 1, 8. 2 plus 5, 7. So now 783.2, right here, 783.2 minus this number. Okay? Now, 2 minus 9, not possible. So from these 3, take 1 here, 2 will become 12, 3 will remain 2. 12 minus 9, 3. Decimal point, okay? Now 2 minus 8. again not possible. So from this 8, take 1, borrow here, it will remain 7. 12 minus 8, 4. 7 minus 7, 0. 7 minus 6, 104.3 is your answer. Okay. Okay, next. Here also same. Now there is subtraction only. So first we'll subtract these two numbers and after that we'll subtract third one. Okay. So let's arrange them. 32.904 minus decimal point here. Before decimal point there is 0. 276. 4 minus 6, not possible. So 4 will become 14. There is 0 here. 0 will become 9 and this 9 will become 8. Okay. Why 0 will become 9? Because from 9, 1 will take borrow here. So there will be 10. Then from that 10, 1 will have taken here. So there will be 9. And here 9 will remain 8. Now 14 minus 6, 8. Okay. 9 minus 7, 2. 8 minus 2 is 6. Decimal point, 2 minus 0, 2, 3 minus nothing, 32. Now from this 32.628, 628, sorry, 32.628 subtract 0.624. Okay? 8 minus 4, 4, 2 minus 2, 0, 6 minus 6, 0.23, 32.004. Understood? So in this way we have to simplify when there are both operations together or three numbers are there for subtraction or three numbers are there for addition. We can do if the numbers, two numbers are in bracket, then solve the operation which is given in the bracket first according to Bodmer's rule. Okay? I hope you understood this addition and subtraction. Pause this video, write these examples and remaining examples in this question. Write by yourself, solve by yourself. Okay? After that, we will see multiplication and division of the fraction. See the next question. Perform the indicated operation in question 31 to question 35. Means in this question, we have to do the multiplication and division. Question number 31. 8.4 divided by 2.1. 32. 4.2 multiplied by 21. Then 33. 4.07 multiplied by 5.5. 34. 2.56 divided by 0.16. Okay. 35th one. I'll show you later. See. Now see, there is division. 8.4 divided by 2.1. Now remember that these are decimal numbers, means these are one kind of fraction only. So while dividing, we are going to use rules of fraction. Okay. Before that, see this decimal fraction, first what we will do, these decimal numbers we will convert into common fraction. We have seen in the first question, second question, okay, decimal numbers we have converted into common fraction. See this 84, 8.4, when we convert into common fraction, how I told you, put finger on the decimal point, which number you can see, 84, that right here. You bar, below the bar, write 1 first, then see after decimal point how many places are there? 1, so put 1, 0. So 8.4 we have converted into the fraction, common fraction. So we have got here 84 upon 10, correct? Divided by 2.1, let's convert 2.1 into common fraction. 2.1 means there will be 21 upon, write 1 here, after decimal point there is 1 digit, so 10. Understood? Both the decimal numbers first we have converted into common fraction. 8.4, that is 84 upon 10 divided by 2.1 is 21 upon 10. Now this is division of fraction which we have seen before. Okay, now division of fraction means what we have to do. First fraction write as it is, 84 upon 10. What to do with the division? Write multiplication instead of division. So multiply by, and what we have to do with the second fraction? We have to write reciprocal of the second fraction. Reciprocal means denominator will go up and numerator will come down. They will interchange in the places. 10 upon 21. Okay, now there is multiplication, and multiplication also we know. Multiply numerator with numerator and denominator with denominator. After that, check whether any numerator is divisible by any denominator. If you see here, both 10 and 10 are in table of 10. That is, if you divide this 10 by 10, 10 ones are 10, and this 10 also 10 ones are 10. Also, we know that 84 and 21 are in which same table? Yes, they are in table of 21. Means 84 is also in table of 21 and 21 is also in table of 21, obviously. So let's divide 21 by 21. 21 ones are 21 and 84 divided by 21. 21 fours are. Okay? 84. Now we have new numerators, 4 multiplied by 1. 4 multiplied by 1, 4, and 1 multiplied by 1, 1, that is 4 itself. So answer is 4. What we have done? First, these decimal numbers we converted into common fractions and all the roots are of fraction only. Understood? So the division of decimal is not difficult at all. Next, there is multiplication. Before these two multiplication, we will solve this 34th one where we have to do division. Okay? Now see. 2.56 divided by 0.16. What to do first? First, let convert these decimal numbers into common fractions. So 2.56, put finger on decimal point. Which number can you observe? 256. Below in the denominator write 1, and after 1 how many zeros will you put? See the decimal places after decimal point, 2 places are there, so put 2 zeros. 100, okay, divide by again here 016 means 16. 016, 0 will come before, but not need to write. Put 1, and after 1, how many zeros will you put? See, after decimal point, how many places are there? 1 and 2. 2 decimal places are there, so put 2 zeros. Okay, now we have division of fractions only. Use same rules. First fraction write as it is, 256 upon 100. Instead of division, write multiplication. And in the fraction, division means multiply applying by reciprocal. Okay. So now multiply numerator with numerator and denominator with denominator. Okay. 100 cut. 100 ones are 100, 100 ones are 100. 256 and 16. Is 256 divisible by 16? Yes, it is. 16 ones are 16. 9 remain. 25 minus 16, 9 remain. 6 came down. 16, 6 are 96. So see, both 256 and 16 are in table of 16. When we divide this 16 by 16, we will get 1. And when we divide 256 by 16, we get 16. 16 into 1, 16. 1 into 1, 1, that is 16 itself. Understood? Now see, 4.2 into 21. 4.2 into, now there is multiplication. Multiplication is also same. What we have to do just, first while multiplying, what to do? Here there is 4.2 into 21. What, while doing multiplication, what we have to do? Forget the decimal point in the number. Read the number without decimal point. Which number we are getting here? 42. Multiply 42 by 21. Okay, 42 multiplied by 21. About decimal point we will think after in the answer. Okay? See now. 42 into 21. 42 into 21. Now see. You know 21, table of 21? Yes, you must know. 21 1 is 21, 21 2 is 42. 2 will come down, 4 will come. Carry. 21 4 is 84. 84 plus 4? 88. Okay? Now think about the decimal point. What we have done? 4.2 into 21. This is the question. Example. First, we wrote number here without without decimal point, and we multiply as usual, as we multiply the whole numbers. As we multiply the whole numbers, according to that, we multiply with the same rules. Now, we got answer 882. So, what 4.2 multiplied by 21 is equal to, first write this 882. Now, see here, we have to put decimal point. First we have forgot decimal point, now that in the answer we have to put that decimal point. Where to put? See now, in these both numbers, after decimal point, how many places are there? That we have to count first. In the first number, after decimal point, how many places are there? Only one. In the second number, is there any decimal places? Means after point, is there any place? No. So there is only one decimal places. So in the answer, we have to put decimal point before one digit from right side. From back side, you have to put before one digit, you have to put decimal point. Okay? It will come here. 88.2. If there will be two decimal places, suppose here there will be decimal point, then this decimal point would have come here. Why? Because this one decimal place, this one decimal place, total two. So it would come here. But now there is only one decimal place, so it will, the decimal point will come before one digit from the right side, from the back side. Okay. See next here, 4.07 into 5.5. First, forget the decimal point and multiply the numbers. 4.07 multiplied by 5.55, 55. Now you don't know 55 table, so first multiply with the 5. 5 sevens are 35. 3 will be carried. 5 zeros are 0 plus 3, 3, and 5 fours are 20, here 0, 5 sevens are 35, 5 will come down, 3 will be carried, 5 zeros are 0 plus 3, 3, and 5 fours are 20, okay, add them, 5 plus 0, 5, 8, 3, 2, 2, okay, now this is our answer. Let's write it. 4.07 multiplied by 5.5 is equal to 22385. Now where to put decimal point? Total how many places are there? Decimal places here in the first number 1 and 2, 2 decimal places, plus in the second number 1 decimal place, total 3 decimal places. Okay, so from right side, from back side, count 3 digit, 1, 2, 3, and before 3 digit put 0, put decimal point. Okay, so it will come here 22.385. So in this way we have to divide and multiply the decimal numbers. Okay, now pause this video and write this in your notebook.